Welcome to Wagon Train Wednesdays, presented by The Archway.
From a young age, Emmeline Wells enjoyed writing poetry and short stories. The skills she developed as a writer came in handy when she later became the editor of a publication called The Women's Exponent and a strong advocate for women's suffrage. Wells was born in Petersham, Massachusetts in 1828. In 1842, her family joined the Mormon Church. She and her first husband, James Harris, moved to Nauvoo, Illinois in 1844. Just after the death of their infant son, James Harris deserted Emmeline and she went on to marry Newell Whitney, a prominent member of the church. Together, they joined the group of Mormons who left Nauvoo in search of religious freedom in the West. They followed the trail along the Platte River through Nebraska and arrived in Salt Lake Valley in 1848. Wells began to devote her time to the work of the church, journalism, and women's suffrage after the birth of her last child in 1862. She joined a Mormon women's organization called the Relief Society and began writing for their publication, The Women's Exponent, in 1873. She became the associate editor of The Women's Exponent in 1875 and served as the editor from 1877 to 1914. Using the pseudonym Blanche Beachwood, Emmeline Wells published 40 articles in The Women's Exponent, arguing for women's educational, economic, and voting rights. Wells' work was nationally recognized, and she was elected a vice president of the National Women's Suffrage Association in 1874. In 1878, she was nominated by the People's Party to become Salt Lake County Treasurer, but turned the nomination down since women were prohibited from holding office in the territory. By 1880, Wells was the leading force involved in a campaign for legislation to grant women the ability to hold office. She wrote that her wish to be a political representative was not an aggressive act on the part of women, but a progressive one, which will remove the discrimination that exists among equal citizens. In 1870, Utah had passed a law that enabled women in the territory to vote. In the mid-1880s, Congress threatened to repeal it. In response, Wells turned the Women's Exponent into a powerful voice for women's rights. She also spent several months personally lobbying for the right to vote in Washington, D.C. Her campaign failed, and Congress repealed women's suffrage in Utah in 1887. In 1889, Wells established the Women's Suffrage Organization of Utah. The organization succeeded in restoring the vote to women in Utah in 1896. After Utah became a state in 1896, Wells campaigned to become a state senator. She was one of several Republican candidates running against a field of five Democrats, including Martha Hughes Cannon, who was running against her own husband. Martha Hughes Cannon won, becoming the first woman to be elected a state senator in the United States. A year before her death, Emmeline Wells was able to celebrate the adoption of the 19th Amendment, which recognized American women's right to vote. Though it had been introduced in 1878, the amendment wasn't adopted until August 26, 1920. The struggle to establish the amendment to recognize a woman's right to vote had taken 42 years. Wells is remembered for her work as a pioneering woman in the Archway's Journey's Outcome exhibit. Learn more about Emmeline Wells and the women's suffrage movement. Find these books at your local library or online. Emmeline B. Wells, An Intimate History by Carol Cornwall Madsen, and The Woman's Hour, The Great Fight to Win the Vote by Elaine Weiss.
Be sure to follow the Archway's Facebook page and check back next Wednesday for another episode of Wagon Train Wednesdays.